Maybe it's just me. Rejections on a dance floor. My buddy George and I are out at the bar, and as a pleasant twist, his boyfriend Johnny has joined us. Johnny's grown tired of hearing about all the adventures we've been having without him. It's a situation that could easily leave me feeling like their third wheel, but I've decided to pretend I've got two hot dates like Colin Farrell at award shows. The dance floor is packed, considering the cover we just paid, it sure as shit better be. And I find a comfy corner with my drink and my dates for some first-class people watching. The scene is straight out of Madonna's Hung Up video, except there's no middle-aged woman shoving people around and dry-humping a ghetto blaster. Not yet, anyway. We lose George pretty quickly as he feels the call of the rhythm and heads out to gyrate with strangers. Johnny and I decide to focus, for the time being, on drinking heavily.
Isn't it fantastic how much easier it is to be a wallflower when there's alcohol involved?
Johnny's right. Back in school, I always felt awkward and exposed when I hung on the wall and watched people dance. But add a decade and a cocktail and you can adopt a knowing above it all expression that says, I would be dancing, but I worry I would spill my overpriced alcoholic beverage. Then, if you keep drinking, eventually dancing might seem like a good idea. When I think about it, it's a little frustrating that I have to have a few, okay, more than a few, vodka tonics before my inhibitions melt and I can get my groove on. Although this may only be true when I'm at home. I think back to my last few excursions out of town and realize that when I travel, I don't think twice about heading right out onto the floor. When I was in Scotland, I'd hit CC Bloom's, which really does exist, and Margaret Cho was right, it is the gayest place on earth. Almost every night, dancing till the wee hours to god-awful Europop and a surprising amount of Destiny's Child. I never gave a second thought to whether I looked like an idiot out there. Of course I did. All gay men look like they're having hormone-induced seizures when they're dancing. That's what makes it fun. I share these observations with Johnny.
That is so funny. I do the same thing whenever I go out of town. If I don't know anybody in the bar, I'm an instant dancing queen.
This begs the question. What is it about being off your home turf that can turn a wallflower into the belle of the ball? Am I really so concerned that I'm going to run into some dude the next day at Kroger who stops me while I'm innocently buying tomatoes to say,
Hey, I saw you dancing last night. It was terrifying. Please don't ever, ever do that again. By the way, I took pictures and showed all my friends, and we laughed a lot.
Okay, apparently that's exactly what I'm afraid of. Did an adolescence filled with awkward school dances convince me I can't happily cut a rug around people I marginally know without fear of judgment? I look at Johnny.
Why are you looking at me like that?
Come on, Johnny. Dance with me. George shouldn't have all the fun.
You're right. Screw it.
I grab Johnny and we join the throngs of shirtless men tripping the light fantastic. And for just a little while, we let go. As the floor rotates, giving me a full view of the room and simultaneously making me feel like a pie on display at Shoney's, but in a good way, I remember that's supposed to be the point. Taking a break from all the slings and arrows of daily existence and celebrating the part of being queer that my straight friends always assume to be true. That we know how to throw down and have a good time. There's so much for me to overanalyze tomorrow when the lighting's not as flattering and the people aren't as ecstatic. Tonight, for once, I'm just having fun.